beautiful, diverse, inspiring. These are the words I like to use to describe the fourth studio EP from Seven Lions. This one's called Creation. Now, in a lot of ways, I feel like words can't even describe what this EP is bringing to the table. If you guys remember with my Illenium album review, I said this is the kind of direction EDM needs to head. It's diverse, it's all over the place, it's beautiful, and this is the kind of sounds I'd like to hear from artists like Seven Lions and other artists in the melodic dubstep scene. And for the most part, I have liked Seven Lions in the past, but nowhere near as much as this EP. This thing is solid gold for sure. Now, I will get literally my only pick with this EP out of the way right now, and that's the fact that a couple of these tracks, including Summer of the Occult and The Journey, seem to be outliers in the EP by the means that they're very hard, a little more experimental. They weren't anywhere near my least favorite tracks on the EP. In fact, I didn't even have a least favorite track on the EP because everything in here is so freaking good. These two are just so different from the other tracks on the album, which are much more melodic, pretty sounding, and more conceptual toward the concept of this EP, with being Creation and everything being very bright, natural, and melodic sounding. These two kind of stick out like a sore thumb a little bit, but that in no way is a bad thing because these two tracks are two of my favorites on the EP. That's literally the only pick I have with the entire thing. Now let's talk about all of the good that this EP brings. We've got Intro, which is a beautifully, beautifully orchestrated track all over the place in terms of the violins and the cellos and everything, orchestrated by Seven Lions. Absolutely gorgeous. Meanwhile, we've got Summer of the Occult, which sounds a little bit more drum steppy. Like I said, it's hard, it's experimental, and kind of reminds me a little bit of where artists like Shadian and Sakura Burst have been doing, just very noisy, not necessarily hip-hop or bass music sounding, but this one is a little bit more experimental, but still remaining on the EDM side with the drum and bass drum step genre, which is immediately followed by Creation, the title track on this, which is a beautiful melodic dubstep track, and classic Seven Lions fans are probably, this is probably going to be their favorite because it's so similar to the kind of styles he's gone in the past. But really, I think it wouldn't have been a good Seven Lions EP without having any kind of regular melodic dubstep in it. And then we get into some of the most diverse and interesting music I have ever heard from Seven Lions. I've liked a lot of his tracks, especially tracks like Worlds Apart, which is one of my favorite melodic dubstep releases of all time. I haven't been extremely into a lot of his EPs though. Some of his bigger tracks include collaborations with Ellie Goulding and Tove Lo. Hearing tracks like those, you can completely throw everything you ever knew about Seven Lions out the window with this EP, because after the point of the title track, he just goes absolutely insane. Coming Home sounds like it came off a Phillip Phillips kind of EP. It's very folk sounding, kind of reminding me a bit of My Only Friend by Project 46, which was on their album, except he does it, in my opinion, a lot better with this. Although it does take that kind of folk sound, it works so well with the EDM infusion on this one, and you'll have to definitely listen to this to be able to kind of understand what I'm saying. It just blends so well, and I've never seen EDM combined with the folk genre so well, even with artists like Avicii doing it in the past. On the other hand, we've got The Journey, which is basically a metal track, and it's got a little bit of the EDM infusion, but for the most part, this is very guitar-centric, and I honestly didn't know Seven Lions had this kind of talent in store for us. Then we get into the festival mix of Falling Away featuring Lights, and a lot of people are going to be like, oh, the generic festival big room dance music, and it's extremely refreshing. When I first heard the single, it was on the Falling Away Remixes EP, and I am so freaking happy he decided to put that from that EP onto this, where I feel like this track absolutely does fit into the EP, and even better than the original could, in my opinion. The melody is just so freaking pretty, and the vocal chops are just on point. That's easily one of my favorites on the EP. Then again, most of the EP is a favorite of mine. Then we get into the closer, Leaving Earth, which honestly sounds to me like it could have come off a Pink Floyd album. That's how good this thing was produced. It's just all over the place with guitars, and the layers behind it are just so melodic and well put together. And it's amazing that an artist like Seven Lions did this all by himself. Extremely impressive. There's only 3 features on this entire EP, and none of them are producers, which is extremely impressive. Overall, this thing just flows so well together, other than I said the small 2 outliers that seem a little bit odd. Intro does flow perfectly into the Summer of the Occult. The fact that the journey comes so oddly between Coming Home and the festival mix of Falling Away is probably my only really big issue with this EP, and it's not even really a big issue, it's a very small issue. Overall, I think this EP was nearly flawless and easily the best work I've heard from Seven Lions, making it more diverse, and it's a little bit easier to do that with an EP, but overall I think I like this one a little bit better than the Illenium album. Probably my favorite project so far this year, including EPs and LPs, extremely impressive and surprising from Seven Lions. I'm going to give this one a 9.5. Now, you know I don't throw those around a lot. I was even considering giving it a 10, but like I said, there is that small issue. So if it's anything less than perfection, to me, I can't really give it a solid 10. Go out and listen to it. Go out and buy it. Support this amazing artist. And this definitely, I wasn't a huge Seven Lions fan before this, but I've definitely been converted into his fan base following the release of this EP. So I love you guys, and I'll see you later. Peace.